Hello viewers, in today's class we are going to take up one important conceptual problem from definite integrals, right? So here we have to integrate this function, that is 1 over x times signum of x minus 2 from 1 to 3, right? So let us start. Now, before proceeding further, let us take a close look at our integrand, which is a combination of reciprocal function and signum function. So 1 over x is our reciprocal function, and in other words, we can also say that 1 over x is our rational function, because the numerator is 1 and denominator is x, and both are 1 and x both are polynomials, right? So this is the rational function, and signum of x minus 2 is our signum function, right? Okay, so now let us proceed further, and let us take the definition of signum function. Now we know that signum of y is equal to plus 1 whenever y is greater than 0, and signum of y is equal to minus 1, or we can take here 0 whenever y is equal to 0, and minus 1 whenever y is less than 0, right? So this is the standard definition of a signum function, right? Now here we have signum of x minus 2. So now this definition can be applied to this function. So signum of x minus 2 is equal to plus 1 whenever x minus 2 is greater than 0, and signum of x minus 2 is equal to 0 whenever x minus 2 is equal to 0, and signum of x minus 2 is equal to minus 1 whenever x minus 2 is less than 0, right? So here y is equal to x minus 2, right? Now if we solve this inequality, we have x is greater than 2, and when we solve this equation, we have x is equal to 2, and when we solve this inequality, we have x is less than 2, right? Okay, so now we have defined this function signum of x minus 2. Now let us take the real number line. So here we have minus infinity, here we have plus infinity, right? Okay, so now here we see that we have the point x is equal to 2. So let us take x is equal to 2 somewhere here, right? Okay, and we see that whenever x is greater than 2, that is this interval. So this interval is x greater than 2, or 2 to infinity is the interval where x is greater than 2. And this interval is x less than 2, that is minus infinity to 2, right? Okay, and here we have the point 2. Now let us see the integral, and here the lower limit is 1 and the upper limit is 3, right? So 1, it lies somewhere here, and here we have 1 and here we have 3. So 1 lies to the left of 2 and 3 lies to the right of 2, right? So now we have to integrate this function from 1 to 3. So now we can break it into the sum of two integrals. One is from 1 to 1 to 2, and other is from 2 to 3, right? 2 to 3. So 2 is our breaking point where we break the limit, right? So the first one is from 1 to 2. Here we have 1 over x, signum of x minus 2 dx, and here we have 2 to 3, and here we have 1 over x, signum of x minus 2 dx, right? Now when x belongs to 1 to 2, 1 to 2, we see that x is less than as 2, right? So when x belongs to 1 to 2 interval, then all the values of x which falls in this interval are less than 2, right? So the value of signum of x minus 2 should be equal to minus 1, right? So we have 1 to 2, 1 over x, and here we have minus 1 for signum of x minus 2, and then we have 2 to 3, 1 over x, and whenever we take x belonging to 2 to 3, then we see that all the values which falls in the interval 2 to 3, the values of x are greater than 2, right? So the value of x greater than 2, so signum of x minus 2 will take the value plus 1, right? So now we have the integral minus, taking this negative sign outside the integral, so we have minus integral from 1 to 2 dx over x, and here we have 2 to 3 and dx over x, right? So now we have two simple integrals here, because integral of 1 over x is log of x. So now here we have minus log of x, and the limits are from 1 to 2, and here we have the integral log of x, and the limits are from 2 to 3, right? Now we'll substitute the limits here. So we have log 2 minus log 1, and here we have log 3 minus log 2, right? So now this can be written as minus log 2 over 1, because log m minus log n is equal to log m over n, right? So this is minus log m minus log n, so log 2 over 1, and here we have log 3 over 2, right? Now we can write this expression as log of half, that is we can take the reciprocal, here we'll have simply 3 over 2. So we have written minus log 2 over 1 as log 1 over 2, because log a over b is equal to minus of log b over a, right? Okay, so now we have log half plus log 3 over 2, which can be written as half log of half times 3 over 2, because log of m plus log of n is equal to log of m times n, right? So now this is equal to log of 3 over 4, right? So now the value of this integral is equal to log of 3 over 4, or this can also be written as log to the base e 3 over 4, or in other words, we can also write it as log of e log base e 3 minus log 4 to the base e, right? So this is the required value of the given integral.